Guys, welcome to Mozak's New World Empire. My name is Sis Strings, and today we'll be discussing about the parts of the guitar and how to tune your guitar. Okay, talking about the parts of the guitar, this is what we call the bridge, and this is what we call the saddles. This helps in holding the strings. And this is what we call the strings. It has six strings. And each of these strings has a name. E, B, G, A, D, and E. And I gave each of these strings a name in order for me not to forget. Okay, let me tell you mine now. Every beautiful girl deserves an egg. I go again. Every beautiful girl deserves an egg. This is the string one, the string two, the string three, the fourth strings, the fifth strings, and the sixth strings. Yeah. And we call this the tuning peg. The tuning peg. It helps you in tuning your guitar. This is what we call the tuning pegs. Okay. This is the head of the guitar. And this is called the neck. This is the neck of the guitar. And this is the body of the guitar. This is called the sound hole, where the sound comes out from. We'll call this the sound hole. And you see this line? This one's like this. In between the strings. We'll call them the frets. It's called the fret. And this is called fret board. It's called the fret board. Yes, no, I won't forget this one. This is called the belt. It helps you in holding the guitar properly. Okay, this is called the knots. The knots, it helps in holding the strings down. It's called the knots. Yes. So, that is that about the guitar. The parts of the guitar, rather. So, let's come to the tuning of your guitar. How to tune your guitar.
Have you been tuning your guitar? Yeah. What do you use in tuning your guitar?
I have an app. It's called Guitar Tuner. I downloaded it. So it helps me in tuning my guitar better.
Okay, you have an app. And then, of course, you know this kind of guitar came with a tuner also.
Yes, a tuner
when you
also.
Put it on, as you are press, as is, you know, it's reading it. Yeah. Let me show you. Those of you that are learning, if you can start with this kind of a guitar, Guitar Tuner is here. You can use this app. So this is a guitar tuner. So you press the E, it's sounding E, so you tune it down. Good. Of course, it will now give you a sound, bang, tell you that what. Okay, so let's press it again. Good. So that's E, so using this is helpful. So what's the next string? I'll go to A. That one is correct. So then D is tuned already. So then I go to G. Correct. So if I go to B. Correct. I go to E. Correct. So the tuner is good. You just mark you whether you are right, whether. Of course, but if you have the ear training over time, you can just know that these strings is not tuned, but it takes time for a musician to master your sound. Once you get your first strings right, a musician that has a very good ear training can just tune the rest, you know, haven't tuned the first one. Of course, there are different type of app. Anyone, I have what they call TuneCore in my own phone. TuneCore is helps me to, as I'm pressing it, is showing me something like this also, and I'm able to tune my instruments. Okay, so that is that for you. You can use a tuner, you can use a keyboard. Another thing you can do, you can use the fifth fret method. The fifth fret method. When you're using the fifth fret method, all you need to do is to tune the first one. So let's assume we have already tuned the first strings. Don't bother yourself with the keyboard again or with the guitar
tuner.
Guitar tuner again. So you just go ahead and look at it. You have your open, you tune it. Then you go to the fifth. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Whatever you get in your fifth fret is the is the same thing as what you get in the next open strings. You see, they are the same. Dun, open. Dun. If you press this fifth again, dun, you use it to get the open of the next one. Dun. You press the fifth again of this other one. You use it to get the open of the next one. Then when you get to the what? The third strings, you go to the fourth. You press it as. You use it to get this other one as. Then you come back to your fifth. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And use it. And then. You use it to get the open of this. So what I mean is. This is what I mean. If you have 1, 2, 3. So here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here is supposed to be your A. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here is supposed to be your D. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here is supposed to be your G. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here is supposed to be your B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here is supposed to be your E. This is what I mean by the fifth fret method. So A, I'm going to get this same A, I'm going to get it in my fifth fret. This same D, I'll get it in my fifth fret. This same G, I'll get it in my fourth fret of the preceding what? Strings. Like that. It's only the third string now that you come back to what? Your fourth fret. Because that's how the guitar is tuned. Okay. But in the bass guitar, it's fifth all through. Because bass guitar, you don't tune this way. Alright, so that's how to tune the guitar. So number one, you can use your keyboard. You can use the guitar apps, a tuner app everywhere. And then you can also use the fifth fret method. Okay, so that is that. The last thing we want to quickly look about is the guitar fretboard chart. Now, how do you get the guitar fretboard chart? Very simple. You already have your what? Open as E, B, G, D. A and E. So in music, generally, the keys of music is, you know, you use letters, capital letters to represent your keys. And then you use letter A, capital letter A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. That is what you use to represent your keys in music. Every other keys that fall also in music, you now be their sharps and flats of this particular keys. So you now begin to have A sharp, you know, B flat. You now begin to have A sharp. What is A sharp? A sharp is the key above A, while B flat is the key below. So flat means backward, while sharp means what? Forward. So if your keys, anything in front of this key is a sharp of that, of the key, anything behind me is my what? Is my flat. So you name other keys relative to what? To this other first keys. Now, before we go ahead, just know that between B and C and E and F, you don't have anything in between them. But every other one has something here. It has something here, it has something here, it has something here, and it has something here. So after G, you start from A again, and then you continue. So there's something here. The only place you don't have something is between your B and C, and your E and F. This is standard, you have to get this. So there's not going to be what you call B sharp, and there's nothing like what? C flat. Do you understand? There's nothing like C flat because there's nothing between B and C. There's nothing like E sharp and there's nothing like what? F flat. So that's because those guys, they are what? Twin. They don't want anything to come in between them. Don't think nothing will ever come between B and C and nothing will ever come between
E and F.
So the marriage between these two keys is permanent. So you have A. After this, there's something I have what? A sharp.
A sharp.
Then I go to B. Between B, there's nothingness. So here I have C sharp. And then I have D. Then I have D sharp. Then I have E. Then I have F. Then I have F sharp. Then I have G. Then I have G sharp. Then I have A. If we are going backward, the same thing becomes what? A, A flat, G, G flat, F, E, F, E. There's nothing between E and F. Abi, we said that. And then E. And then this D sharp becomes what? E flat. You have your D. This D is same thing as what? D flat. And then C. There's nothing between here. We said it. So B. And then what? B flat. So in other words, this A sharp is same thing as B
flat.
B flat. C sharp is same thing as what? D flat. D sharp is the same thing as what? E flat. G. F sharp is same thing as G flat. G sharp is same thing as what?
A flat.
A flat. So you start from A. Any key you start from, you can start to start from C. Just make sure your end is what? In C. If you start from C, where do you end?
C.
You end from C. If I start from B, where do I end?
B.
I end B. So or you continue till infinitum. So the same thing, if you understand this, you can now come and fill in the fret board yourself. How do you feel it? So let's start from E and list and name the frets as we go. So E, F, F sharp, G, G sharp,
A,
A,
A sharp,
A sharp,
B,
B,
C,
C,
C sharp,
C sharp, and so on,
and so forth.
So D, isn't it? And then if you start from B, what do you have? C.
C sharp.
C sharp.
D.
D.
D sharp.
D sharp.
Then
E.
F.
F.
F sharp.
F sharp.
G.
G.
G sharp.
G sharp.
A.
A.
A sharp.
Like that. And so on and so forth. Then G.
G sharp.
G sharp.
A.
A.
A sharp.
A sharp.
Then B. C.
B. C.
C sharp.
C sharp. D.
D sharp.
D sharp,
E,
E,
F,
F, and so on, D, and D, and so on and so forth. So that is, so automatically you know how the fretboard is. Just starting from, you just know E, B, G, D, A, E. Every beautiful girl deserves an egg, according to her. Then you now, from E, you now have F, F sharp, G, G sharp, like that. If you now want to use the flat, you can also use the flat. The A, G sharp is same thing as what? A flat. Why A sharp is between is same thing as what? B flat. So depending whether you want to use the sharp or you want to use the flat, you can go ahead and use it. All right, that's all about the fretboard. And do you think they have any question? If you have any question, what do you do? Just go ahead and drop it in the comment box below so that we can look at it. So if I were you now, just pick my book. I'll draw a long, you can do a fretboard that is as long as anything. As long as what? You keep going. After G, you start from A, like that. You just continue going, continue going, continue going. So do as much fretboard as your guitar can accommodate. Practically now, where is this? Give me this key. What key is this? The first thing to know which key is this, you ask yourself, what is these strings? What strings is this? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is what? Every beautiful girl deserves. This is key D. Abi? And I'm asking you what, which key is this? So, you have your D as open. D, D sharp, E, F, F sharp, G, G sharp, A, A sharp, B. This is key B. So, which key is this? T strings. You go to your E strings and say E what?
F.
F
sharp.
Uh-huh.
G.
Uh-huh.
G sharp.
Uh-huh.
A.
Mm-hmm.
A sharp. B.
Mm-hmm.
C.
Mm-hmm.
C sharp.
Mm-hmm.
D.
Mm-hmm.
D sharp.
Mm-hmm.
Then
E. So, that is what? Key E. You know the keys from the ones you already know. It's only you know, gurus or professionals that just, you just press here, they know it's key, whatever. Do you understand? And then you see these dots that they put here, these markers. These are fretboard markers. This markers is the one telling you over time, you know this marker, you know this marker, you just know, you use it to measure your fret and just, so that you to be counting 1, 2, 3, 4 and be going from these fret markers, these fretboard markers, you now begin to understand, okay, this place is this place. That's how you see a guitarist will just leave here, whoa, I'm going to pick a note. But what is guiding that guy from leaving here and just going to pick a note is these fretboard markers. But as a beginner, you need to just start counting from, either you're counting from your E, and then this is E. If I want to now know here, this is my E string. So I know E, F, F sharp, G, G sharp,
A,
A sharp, B, C, C sharp, D, D sharp, E, and F. Look at it. That's my key, F. So that is how we are going to go ahead how to get your chord yourself. Next week, we're going to show you how to play C chord, G chord, A chord, E chord, D minor chord, D major chord, and so on. A major chord, A minor chord, G, E, all the major and minor chord of your normal floor keys or the white keys of the piano. So we're going to get the basic chords of the guitar. That's the open chord now next week. So having understand the fretboard, if I told you that a chord is C E G, how do you draw out the C E G? It means anywhere you see E, you know you are pressing it. Anywhere you see C, you are pressing it. Anywhere you see the first come first serve, and I've seen E, I press it. I've seen G, first come first serve. I've seen C, first confessor. I've seen E. So this automatically gives you my word, C major chord. You see, look at C major chord. From here now, one of your finger is here, one of your finger is here. This one is an open strings. This one is open, this one is open, this one is open. So I'm only pressing 3. 1, 2, 3. All right, guys. I think we put an end to it right here. Teaching, what do you have to say to your students?
All right, guys. I hope you guys have learned a lot, because me, I've learned so many how to tune my guitar and my guitar fretboard. I've learned a lot. Please don't forget to subscribe. Please subscribe to get more videos. By next week, Tuesday, we'll be loading more for you. Thank you so much, guys. See you on Tuesday. Bye.